أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الأئمة والمهديين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I seek refuge with Allah from the shaitans of the jinns and the humans. And may Allah send His peace and blessings upon Muhammad and the family of Muhammad, the Imams and the Mahdis. On the 2nd of Muharram, in the year 1435, Hijri Qamari, in the Gregorian year of 2012, on Friday, during the Friday prayer, the private residence and gathering place of the Ansar of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam, a group which is peaceful and believes in Islam and in the teachings of Imam Ahmad al-Hassan alayhi salam, in Egypt, was raided by the Egyptian National Security. They entered the residence and asked for the passports of the individuals, and they found six individuals with expired visas, and they were only expired for a few days, and they sent them back to their countries. One of them was mentally challenged. They left the rest of the Ansar, since they had not committed any crime. "We are not a terrorist group. We have pregnant women and children with us." The nationalities of the Ansar are American, British, Egyptian, French, Trinidadian, Algerian, Pakistani, Serbian, Turkish, German, Swedish, and many more. They were in Egypt legally and would always go to renew their visas, and the ones whose visas expired were only expired recently, and there is a window of 15 days which the government allows to renew the visa. Nonetheless, after the incident and after the National Security left us, after we had contacted our embassies, the Egyptian press, which is known for its lies and deceit, and the Egyptian press, which is influenced by the Wahhabi regime and school of thought of Saudi Arabia, printed lies about us in order to push the Egyptian extremists to harm us. The Egyptian press, along with its associate websites, newspapers, and news channels, said about us that we were terrorists and under investigation for terrorism. They said we were responsible for the killing of the Egyptian border guards. They said we were planning assassinations of the high-level assassinations and the assassination of the Egyptian president, Mohamed Morsi. If this was true, then why am I speaking to you today? Why are they not arrested? Why are the Ansar of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam free without a single charge against them? We committed no crime. We met together to talk and discuss our beliefs, hang out, and we were open and recorded our lectures and posted them online for all of the world to see. Yet these lies against us prove that Egypt is not democratic. The Egyptian press is not free. The Egyptian press is not telling the truth. The Egyptian government is not telling the truth. Their actions are despicable. Their racism is apparent, and their speech is nothing but hypocrisy and lies. We need the support of all of you around the world to help us at this dark time. Help us that we tell the world the truth. Help us that we expose these lies before the Egyptian press gets away with its lies and the Wahhabis and Salafis have an excuse to murder us. Help us before the Egyptian government assists in murdering us by not taking legal actions against these lying reporters. May Allah curse all the liars infinitely and forever. We are free and not guilty of anything. We are Muslims. We are human beings. We bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is His messenger. And they say, "We are Israelis." There is not a single Israeli among us, nor has there ever been. We want justice. Please take action now and call the BBC and CNN and Al Jazeera and every foreign media newspaper and radio and station. Contact everyone and every media outlet you can and inform them of the danger we are in and how we are not free in this supposed democratic land. Expose them and tell the truth. Ansar of Allah, speak on our behalf to your news sources. Tell them you are our friends and defend us. Tell the news outlets to come to Egypt and see what situation we are in. Tell them about how the world is being lied to. We never carried a weapon in this country, nor will we ever. We do not involve ourselves in politics and have never spoken about the president of Egypt nor about the police or government. We do not have anything to do with that. We are people of peace. We are people of a different school of thought. And we believe in Imam Ahmad al-Hassan alayhi salam, the Yamani, and the promised messenger to the Muslims from the Mahdi alayhi salam, and the promised messenger to the Christians from Jesus alayhi salam, and the promised messenger to the Jews from Elijah alayhi salam, and we force our beliefs on no one. We are not propagating a religion on the streets of Egypt. We are making YouTube videos. Is this our crime? Shame on the Egyptian President Mohamed Morsi. Shame on the Egyptian government. Shame on the Egyptian media if they do not stand up for the truth and if they do not stand up for us. If they do not stand up for the democracy which they claim to believe in. Shame on Egypt and the Egyptians for allowing such lies and believing them. The clerics of Egypt, like Mohammed Hassan, are holding news conferences and gatherings as you are watching this video, talking about how we are an extremist and radical group and how to eliminate us. Stand up for us, O believers. Stand up for us, O believers in freedom. Stand up for us, O human beings. A silent one when it comes to the truth is a mute devil. If our blood spills in this land of Egypt, you will partake in it if you do not help us with every breath you have. Protect us with your actions. Protect us with your words and speak out. Make the world listen. Tell the media the following. Tell them there are a group of foreigners in Egypt, and there are Egyptians among us as well, whom are being surrounded and accused and slandered by the Egyptian media as a terrorist group and accused of all kinds of hideous crimes that we did not commit. They illegally raided our homes without a warrant, or at least they did not show us the warrant and refused to. They are pushing people to want to kill us. Tell the media Egypt is not democratic. Tell them citizens of the United States of America and Britain and Serbia and Tunisia and Germany and France and Belgium and Pakistan and Sweden and Egypt and many other countries are being slandered by the Egyptian press in an attempt to eliminate any freedom of religion from this society. Tell them our lives are threatened and they have a journalistic obligation and duty to investigate what is happening to us in Egypt, especially since it is making national news and national headlines. In fact, it is making international headlines with Russia media calling us and saying about us that we are terrorists and suspected for terrorism and assassinations. And the Swedish media is already even writing about us. Tell them this story uncovers how oppressive and tyrannical Egypt is and how we are not free. Tell them we are minorities in a country and we are being exterminated. Tell them and tell them and tell them. Tell them about how the six individuals whom were taken were put in inhumane conditions in an extremely filthy environment to the point where they could not even pray. Wake up the world. Tell the world your friends and brothers and sisters are being cornered and this is a part of a wider plan of extremist Sunni domination of Egypt. We are also Egyptians. Egyptians whom participated in the revolution and we are not given the freedom to religion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse the oppressors. We demand an apology and clarification from the Egyptian media and country, and we demand to be given our rights fully and to be allowed to worship in peace and privately without fear of murder. We demand the state of Egypt to protect us as it protects everyone else here. We demand that Egypt allow the Ansar of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam the freedom of thought and religion and the freedom to gather, or else the curse of Allah will be upon them. Is not the curse of Allah upon the oppressors? Thank you all. All praises due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. Please begin working as soon as possible. Contact every news media outlet. Contact everybody you know and let them know that there are Egyptian and foreign citizens whose lives are at risk for nothing more than believing in a peaceful school of thought, the peaceful teachings of Imam Ahmad al-Hassan the Yamani. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد إلهم والمهدينا وسلم تسليما كثيرا
هضماني
هضماني هضماني
هضماني يا أبويا
هضماني هضماني
سكن العزيزة وسلوتك يا أبويا هضماني
هضماني هضماني يا أبويا
سكن العزيز صاحي بحالي من ودا يعيتني بويا لا ميحنا وثنياني وتيمر ببالي يلدليتني بويا علي ظلت بلا والي يلي يتميتني بويا يتموني من زغري يتموني ليش انحرم من شافي يا ابويا هضموني
هضموني هضموني يا ابويا هضموني 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 يا ابويا
بدي يا امام خضاب بويا بويا ومثل طيري.
وفي هذه الرواية بين أن منبر المهدي قد سبق المهدي إلى مصر، أي أنه منبر قد هيئوا قبل ذلك نجباءه